shot if I mean.
Yeah, go for it.
Rise.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, welcome to this day of celebration. It's great to have all of you here today to witness the union of Jenifer and Adam as wife and husband before God. Together, we will share in the joys of their wedding, both with the celebration of love between Jenifer and Adam and the love shared between those who surround them. Jenifer and Adam, I am truly honored and overjoyed that you have asked me to be a part of this blessed event. This will be a memory that I will cherish for the rest of my days here on earth. Thank you. It is one of life's richest surprises when the fateful meeting of two individuals leads them to proceed together along a common path. It is indeed one of life's finest experiences when a chance relationship grows into a permanent bond of love. This meeting and this love are what bring us here together today. If I speak in the tongues of men or angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, and it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always preserves. Love never fails. Jenifer and Adam, you two have the opportunity to build an amazing life together. You are blessed to share this experience with the loved ones gathered with you here today to support you as you mark this journey together. On this day, with love, we will forever bind you together. Who gives this bride today?
Her grandmother and mother.
Jenifer and Adam, a good marriage must be created. In marriage, it's the little things that are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful in life. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. Most marriage vows will include the phrase, for better or for worse. In a truly solid marriage, these are more than mere words. They mean that you will always be there to protect the other one in the face of adversity. They mean that each of you will be there to support each other physically, mentally, and spiritually. They mean that you will form a bond that is stronger than any steel or man-made thing found on this earth. A bond that cannot be broken by mere mortal man. Ecclesiastes 4 tells us, two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. And a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. This Ecclesiastes passage refers to a cord of three strands. The cord of these three strands represents marriage. The first strand being the bride, the second strand being the groom, and the third strand, which binds them together, is God. At this time, I would like to ask Mr. Steve Sneed to please lead us in a prayer.
Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we are so thankful to be here today to witness this wedding for Jen and Adam. We're thankful for the beauty of today and for the opportunity to be here. We pray for everyone that's here, for those who've traveled here, that you will give them safe passage as they return home. We thank you for Jen and Adam and their commitment to one another. We pray that they will always keep you first in their marriage and in their lives. We're truly thankful that you brought them into our lives, and we thank you that we were able to be a part of their lives. We just thank you, Lord, that you blessed us this day, as you do each and every day. Help us to always give you the glory for the good in our lives. We just thank you for allowing us to live in this country that you've provided for us. We're thankful for all those who serve, like Adam, for all the sacrifices they put forth. We pray that you'll bless this marriage, help it to last many, many years, help us all to be a part of it and be encouraging to them. We just thank you so much that you love us, that you take care of us, and that you sent your son to die on the cross on our behalf. It's his name we pray. Amen.
Jenifer and Adam, now it's time we exchange vows. Jenifer, you first. Repeat after me. I, Jenifer. Take you, Adam.
Take you, Adam.
For my lawfully wedded husband.
For my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In the good times and in the bad.
In the good times and in the bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All of the days of my life.
All of the days of my life.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Adam, repeat after me. I, Adam.
I, Adam.
Take you, Jennifer.
Take you, Jennifer.
For my lawfully wedded wife.
For my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and bad.
In good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you. All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Now this is the part where I ask y'all to join hands, but you already got it handled, so there we go. Jennifer, do you take Adam to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
By making this commitment, you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage. Do you promise to honor him in love, to be sensitive to his needs, to comfort him in difficulty, and to put your full and complete trust in him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Adam, Do you take Jenifer to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
By making this commitment, you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage. Do you promise to honor her in love, be sensitive to her needs, to comfort her in difficulty, and to put your full and complete trust in her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the part of the ceremony where generally the bride and the groom light a candle or pour sand to show their unity. In this particular case, Adam and Jenifer are going to place their family brand on a piece of barn wood from Jennifer's great-great-grandfather's barn. We'll be moving there. Y'all just stay there, you're fine. The wedding ring's circular shape reflects the unending power of love, a force with no beginning and no end. You both should wear these rings proudly and let them remind you each day of your commitment to one another. I, Jenifer.
I, Jenifer.
Give you Adam.
Give you Adam.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your fingers.
I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
I commit my whole of my whole of my heart and soul to you.
I promise to cherish you.
I promise to cherish you.
For the rest of my days.
For the rest of my days.
I give you all that I am.
I give you all that I am.
And accept all that you are.
And accept all that you are.
Adam, please repeat after me. I, Adam.
I, Adam.
Give you Jenifer.
Give you Jenifer.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
I promise to cherish you.
I promise to cherish you.
For the rest of my days.
For the rest of my days.
I give you all that I am.
I give you all that I am.
And accept all that you are.
And accept all that you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, by the authority vested in me by the great state of Texas, I am pleased to pronounce Jenifer and Adam as husband and wife, sealed together today in both law and in love. Adam, you may kiss your bride. Gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure and honor to be able to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Jenifer Ruffin. Been asked to let you know that there will be snacks and drinks available here in the hall. Give the party about a half an hour for pictures and all that other post-wedding stuff, and then dinner will be served. So thank you. Please stay and enjoy yourselves.